we will have stock for South Africa in April, and then it should roll. You know, it's been a scale up. May would be a bit more, and June a bit more. I think the procurement of the vaccine is no longer the core. It's going to be how quickly we roll it out.
Are you nervous at this juncture as to how quickly you can roll it out, given the demand?
I was really anxious between Christmas and now, and I got even more anxious around AstraZeneca when they pulled out. And then you realize that it's not going to be that easy to get the other vaccines. And our only real access was through J&J. All along, you know, I watched all sorts of crazy things. I mean, it's amazing where people get things saying, oh, Aspen are going to export all 300 million doses. And it wasn't really for me to comment. It's for J&J to comment. It makes it a little bit difficult. But, you know, our arrangement with J&J was, and there's always been around equitable access. Sort of, so when we had presentations, I'd make comments like, you've got to be in a good position if you're making in South Africa. But the anxiety, certainly once I started to see the trial batches go so well and the validation batches, I sort of started to breathe a sigh of relief. And certainly now we're in a good position because I know we can do it. Remember, we never made a biologic in that facility. And it's not like a tablet, you stand up and you sweep it off the ground. If you break one of those vials by hitting the fridge, for example, when you take it in, you evacuate the whole building, you've got a biological scare. So it was a different level. Great work with the J&J team. They've been great in transferring skills, and the skills are now in the country. My anxiety has dissipated. I'm always on guard because every million or 2 million more we make in a month is really important to everyone, not just in South Africa, everyone around the world.